Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss types of earth retaining walls from the chapter Earth Pressure Theory. So, the first type of retaining wall is a gravity retaining wall. These are the heavyweight retaining walls. So, here in this figure, we can see a retaining wall. This wall depends upon their weight for the stability. Means whatever pressure which is acted on this retaining wall is resisted due to the heavy weight of this retaining wall. These walls are usually constructed on a plain concrete or masonry. Such walls are not economical for large height because if the height is large, the pressure exerted by the soil on the retaining wall will be large. So for that we will require to construct more or heavier structure, and that will require more material or more concrete. So that won't be economical. So these gravity retaining walls are suitable for small height. The second type of retaining wall is a semi-gravity retaining wall. Here in this figure we can see a semi-gravity retaining wall. In case of purely gravity retaining wall, we require more material to add more weight to achieve stability. But the size of this retaining wall can be reduced if a small amount of reinforcement is provided near the back face. So here in this figure we can see that the small amount of reinforcement is provided at the back face as well as at the base. So, the size of this retaining wall can be reduced. Such walls are known as semi-gravity retaining wall. The third type of retaining wall is a cantilever retaining wall. These type of retaining walls are made up of RCC, that is reinforced cement concrete. The wall consists of a thin stem and a base slab which are casted monolithically. So here in this figure we can see that the stem and the base slab both are casted monolithically, means they are casted as one unit and there is no joint between stem and base slab. This type of retaining walls are found to be economical up to a height of 6 to 8 meters. The next type of retaining wall is counterfort retaining wall. So, counterfort retaining wall have a thin vertical slab known as counterfort. These are spread across the vertical stem with the base slab. So, in this figure we can see this part, means this vertical slab is called as counterfort, and they are spread throughout the length of this retaining wall. Thus, a vertical stem and the base slab span between this counterfort. The purpose of providing the counterfort is to reduce the shear force and bending moments in the vertical stem and the base slab. These counterforts are generally on the side of the backfill. So, these are provided on the side of backfill. Thank you for watching.